What is up, my favorite YouTubers? Alex here in 95, bringing you guys a deck of the month for January 2012, the first deck of the month of the year. Sadly, it's the end of the format. We'll know the list in a couple weeks, hopefully by February 20th, give or take, 24th, so probably like 3 weeks left, 4 weeks left maybe, until we know the list for the March 2012 list. So this is just a fun deck I made. It's kind of competitive because it's counter fairies, but I hate this format, and it does fine, especially on DN testing, but DN's not really a legitimate testing source for things against the meta. But again, it does great against windups and insectors, so I'm just gonna, you know, go straight into it. It's a pretty standard build. Three Thunder Kings. The only thing it conflicts with is your Pot of Dualities, but you know, they're great and negate. It's one of the best monsters in this game aside from Tour Guide. Opening with this card is really amazing. Just because you can just summon it, and like everything just revolves around like exceeds and synchros for the most part, more so exceeds right now. So he just stops everything, and he really just slows down opponents. But if you have dead dualities in your hand, you can just keep these in your hand and then like use them for discard fodder for cards like Divine Wrath. So it's never really dead. And if they do manage to get rid of it, or you use it to negate something or whatever, then you broke even, and then you're gonna get something with duality after. Bountiful Artemis, one of my favorite cards in the deck. He's basically the centerpiece. He lets you just draw a card off of each counter trap you play, so, or your opponent, obviously. So, you know, it's a great card. I like it overall. I only run one bend out. Oh, the only issue I have with it is it gets run over by a lot of stuff, so you gotta be smart. Don't just plop these down. It's not like in the past where you just plop down two or three Bountifuls and just expect to draw cards, because people can run these over really easily now, especially if you only have counter traps in the back row that don't actually protect you. So, I only run one Vandalgen. You only need one because, you know, I believe you run 10 or 11 counter traps, and there's not too many scenarios where you always just want to have this, you know, like, it's a great card. I think it's a one of maybe two, but I feel one is just the most consistent. I hate drawing dead Vandalgens. I hate Honest, but I have to run it because pretty much everything I run is light, almost. And just lets you run over stuff. It's like one of your line of defense against this guy, and I love just using him, summoning him, and just poking with him, bouncing him back. So he's okay, and he's a great defense. He prevents like Thunder Kings and stuff from running him over. I actually run triple Veiler. I had triple Divine Wrath and double Veiler, but I think double Veiler is a little, it's not bad, but I feel like triple Veiler just, it always reassures me, like, regardless if I draw it in doubles, because I can always negate something with one, and then the other one, I can just use it to go into Trishul or whatever if I have, like, a Bountiful and, like, a Thunder King for some reason. So, he's great. You have to run him. And I also bumped it up to three because I took out three Maxes in this deck. I didn't like Maxi in this deck anymore just because, you know, it's counter traps and they're not always going to want a special summon. I only run one Cyber Dragon. This was a last minute add, and it helps you run over stuff. After windups do their push and you like stop them with like Divine Wrath or Veiler, and suppose like they have a couple cards on their field, like a couple monsters, you can just use them for Cyber Dragon, make Chimera Tech. And then you can't do it with all of them, but I think Shark, or no, there's a couple of them you can do it with. I think Zen Mighty and like some other one, but is also great. It's just a floater for the most part, and it's good against Karakuris if you play against them. The one Grandmole, you know, just bounce stuff. He's great. This is a really iffy card. Morphing Jar. You have to be careful when you use this. Especially make sure you don't use this. If you don't know you're playing against Dark Worlds yet, don't use this card, because if you're playing against Dark Worlds, you're probably gonna get screwed, and they're gonna plus really heavily off of it. But it's great if you have like massive back rows, or like two or three back rows and a Bountiful, and you have this set, and then you just flip it next turn, and then they have to Veiler it unless they want you to plus. If they don't, then you're gonna get more counter traps and just put them in a really shitty situation. This is one of the iffiest things of the game, in the deck. I opted to actually not run Gores. I'm not running this card. I usually do. I've always ran it in counter fairies, but because of the back rows and the way this format plays out, I always have a back row just because you like to one for one or a plus one usually with this deck, and you always like to just have one to two back rows max unless you have a Starlight Road. So instead of the Gores, you could side it if you want, but you know, I feel like the one Trigodia just replaces the Gores because you're always going to be drawing cards off Bountiful, and you know, just drawing a lot of stuff, so it's great. Spells, we run triple Duality. We run one Smashing Ground just as an out to cards like Spirit Reaper, so it's fine. I like it. The staples, you know, Book of Moon, Mind Control, Reborn, Dark Hole, Heavy, and only one MST. I recommend trying to side the one more or two more just in case against like Royal Decree and stuff, because this deck really doesn't care about too much about OTKing. Like, you just want to control with it. That's why. For the traps, you run Dust Shoot, and then your counter traps, your Triple Solemns, Triple Bribes. Be careful with these. Don't just use them randomly, like stupidly, especially the bribes if you don't have a Bountiful out. One Magic Drain. It's an iffy card, but, you know, spells are really prominent aside from monster effects. We run double Divine Wrath. I already explained that. One Black Horn of Heaven. You only need one just because, you know, you're going to be stopping a lot of the other stuff with your other counter traps and disrupting plays. So one's enough, and it's counter trap. So we only run one Drastic Drop Off. Again, same as Morphing Jar. You don't want to, you know, if you play against Dark Worlds, you don't want to have potentially 3 to 4 dead cards in your deck, so you only run one. If you have this and like Triple Bountiful, you're going to immensely plus. But just one Torrential, one Deep Prison, and one Compulse. These are just my one ofs. I couldn't find any room for any more because you're going to be disrupting plays, so you're not always going to need all the defense, but this is all the defense you usually need. And they're chainable, so yeah. That and two Starlight Roads, so those are pretty obvious. The extra deck, I'm just gonna go right through it. Anti-Jewish card. You guys gotta have your bitches. I can't actually show those on here. Chimera Tech. I couldn't find a Steelsworn Roach to put in here, but you need a Steelsworn Roach. So Utopia, pretend there's a Steelsworn Roach here. Leviathan, Levier, Army Arm, Cataster, Magical Android, Bryonak, one Black Rose. You need double Stardust because of the double Starlight Road. One Scrap Dragon, one Trishula, and one just random fucking Decisive Armor thing in this. So yeah, you try the extra MSTs. Please thumbs up this video. I have to make this video fairly short. So yeah, try the MSTs. You could try Forbidden Lances, great card in here. You could put in Maxes if you want. I just couldn't find the room. I took them out. They were really dead for me because I always draw them like when I don't need them, and I don't draw them when I do need them. So it's a great card. If you guys want a cool site also, just to keep you guys up, I have some links in the description. One of my friends, Thomas Bo, has been writing for the TCG Player. He's giving out really great tips on the game and some cool techs. So you guys can either try the link down below, TCG Player. He's starting to write articles. I highly recommend him. He's been topping a lot of events. You guys can also try ARG articles. There's a lot of stuff for ARG. Hopefully I'll start writing for Alter Reality Games pretty soon. So yeah, go check out Thomas Vo, a really chill guy. The link will be there, his channel will be here, but check out his link. I highly recommend reading the articles. So shout out to him. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Please thumbs up this video. I'm sorry it was fast, but I tried to rush it because I have like 30 seconds left on this camera. So yeah, please let me know what you think of it. It's great. You just want to disrupt your opponent's plays. Don't focus so much on the defensive aspect. So just save your defensive cards, like your Torrential, Deep Prison, and whatnot. So yeah, just save those. Be smart with your plays. And yeah, peace YouTube. Thumbs up this video, please. I'll try to make more videos consistently. So thumbs up this video. And I hit 1 million video views. That's amazing. I just realized that, and 7,000 plus subscribers. So thank you, everyone. Thumbs up. Check out Thomas Vo's articles. Really help you become a better player. And yeah, check out new videos coming up. Thumbs up this video, and I have the hiccups, so yeah, thumbs up fail. Oh, thumbs up for the bitches, thumbs up for the bitches, the random bitches, there they are, the bitches. I'll give you guys the toll-free number. Thumbs up, guys.